programs piece first, or like the grants program first. That's an annual program. Any nonprofit in the county can apply. As I said, we just finished that session. Now we haven't announced those awards yet. We'll be announcing them in 2 weeks' time. We have a final board meeting a week from today, and when that board finally meets, we'll announce those. But in the past, we've done Foothills Food Hub, both infrastructure, health building part of the Food Hub, and then COVID-19, we funded a huge amount of money towards that, plus got the community involved in actually funding actual food during the COVID time. McDowell EMS with World Care and Team, the community paramedics, we had an additional person on there. It's a second year of funding that's been awarded up till now. And it was to increase the after hours and weekend use of community paramedics during that time. McDowell Schools, very involved with bringing in on the elementary school side. We brought in a counselor, a coordinator looking at kids at risk and recognizing that you need to get them at elementary school, at high school, it's sometimes too late. Although there's a counselor at high school, we introduced a counselor at elementary school stage to keep doing that. And we've got some great programs we want to do with them. Just to summarize, and others, McDowell Mission Ministries, most of you know, we've been with them. Ken at Counseling, we've helped. Foothills Food District, Foothills Health, we've helped. Center for Rural Health Innovation, which is telemedicine to schools, we funded that. Centro Unido, we funded this year for the first time. They had a community health worker in the area, the Latinx community, we funded that. West Marion Community Forum, reaching out to African American communities, very especially, funded a program with them as well. If you move on to the next page, we'll talk about leverage funds. So that's our general gateway funding program. The leverage fund is a very interesting one. We actually assist other nonprofits to get funds. There's a lot of money on the table. About 11% of actual funding comes to Western North Carolina of what is available state and federal. Percentage-wise, it should be 18%. That's the percentage ratio that we are. We're losing about 8 or 9% of federal and state funding for two reasons. The organizations don't have the ability to ask. They don't have somebody to write the grant for them. And the second is they don't actually ask. They just forget to ask. It just passes them by. They don't know about it. So we do two things. We work with, we pay for professional grant writers, government partners with us, and we pay for a grant writer to write certain, grant writers write exceptionally well on certain kinds of grants. We pay that grant writer to do that. Organization has no costs at all. We just physically pay for the grant writer, find them and connect with them. And secondly, we write grants for them as well. We at Gateway do grant writing as well. So those are the two ways we actually manage the leverage fund.